Hello and welcome to Controllers Tech. This is part 2 of the video covering the UART peripheral on the ESP32 using the ESP IDF. In the previous video we saw how to use the UART to communicate with the computer. We simply use the ESP32 to transmit and receive the data from the computer using the UART. In today's video, we will see how to make use of the received data to perform some action on the MCU. Basically, we will control a LED connected to the ESP32 using the commands sent by the computer via the UART. We will continue where we left the previous project. Let's open the Expressif IDE and import the previous project to it. Browse the project folder and click Finish. Here the project has been loaded into the IDE, let's build it once. Alright, the build is finished successfully. Let's rename the project to UART Part 2. We need to build it one more time now. In the last project, we created two tasks. The TX task was responsible for sending the data every 1 second, while the RX task was looking for the data sent by the computer. Now let's assume that I don't want the TX task to send the data periodically. Instead, it should only send data when a particular condition is met. In this case, that condition is if the MCU receives some data from the computer. I will show this in detail. Let's change the buffer size to 100 bytes. Here I am changing the data string to be sent by the TX task. Basically, we will send back the data received by the MCU from the computer, along with some modification. The RX data is a local array, so we will have to define it globally. After the modified data has been stored in the data buffer, the UART write bytes function will transmit the data. Now, instead of giving a delay here, we will suspend the task itself. The task suspend can be used to suspend any task, and passing the null parameter suspends the task from which this function is being called. Let's delete this num variable as we don't need it. The task suspension and resume is not enabled by default. So you need to enable it in the FreeRTOS header file. Hold the control button and click on the FreeRTOS header file. Now scroll down to include vtask suspend and set t to 1. Now save the file and close it. So this TX task will send the data once, and then it will be suspended until it is resumed again. We will resume the suspended TX task in the RX task. We have defined the RX data as a global array, so let's delete this array allocation here. Also change the data buffer to RX data buffer. We want the TX task to transmit data only if the RX task has received some data. So we will resume the TX task only if the RX bytes is greater than 0, which means if there is some data received by the MCU. The vtaskResume function is used to resume any suspended task. The parameter of this function is the task handle, which we want to resume. The task handle is allocated to a task when it is created. Here you can see the last parameter of the X task created is the pointer to the task handle, but by default a null is being passed here. In order to set a specific task handle for the TX task, we will first define a task handle globally. And then pass the address of the task handle as the last parameter of the X task create function. This will assign the TX task handle as the official task handle of the TX task. Now we can use this task handle to control the TX task anywhere in the entire code. So to resume the TX task, we will pass the TX task handle as the function parameter. So if the RX task receives some data from the UART, it will resume the TX task. The TX task will modify the received data and send it back to the UART. After sending the data, it will go back to suspension and wait for the RX task to resume it again. We have an error in the RX data definition. Let's pass the number directly here. Alright, there is another error in the sprintf function. Let me set this to 150 as the RX data itself is 129 bytes in size. The error is due to this quotation mark. Let's change this to a single quotation. Alright, the code builds fine now, let's flash it to the board. Let's open the terminal, so that we can see the received data. I am using another serial terminal on the computer, and the configuration is the same as what we used in the previous project. Let's send the string hello. You can see the ID terminal shows the data it has received, and we also got the modified data on the serial monitor. So everything is working fine. The TX task only sends the data when the RX data receives something from the computer. Just like this, you can set some other condition in the code, which will resume the TX task. There is still one issue with the current setup though. If we reset the MCU, the TX task will still run once, and we will receive something in the output. This is because when the TX task is created, it will run once before going into suspension. We can still prevent it by defining this RX bytes as a global variable, and then writing an if condition inside the TX task. Or create a new TX task inside the RX task, and then terminate the task again after it runs once. There are a lot of possibilities, and I will leave it up to you. Now we will control a LED using the command received from the computer. I am not going to use the onboard LED, as it is connected to the same pin which is used by the UART 0. Instead, I have connected an external LED to the board. Here is how the final connection looks like. The UART connection has already been explained in the previous video, so I will skip that. I have connected the LED to pin 13 of the ESP32 dev board. The positive pin of the LED is connected to this pin 13, while the negative pin is connected to the ground. There is also a 100 ohms resistor connected between the ground and the LED, to reduce the voltage supplied to the LED. Let's define the LED pin as GPIO13. Now write a new function to configure the LED. Inside this function, we will first reset the LED pin. And then set the GPIO direction for the LED pin as output. Inside the main function, call this LED configuration function we just defined. The LED will be controlled based on the command sent by the computer via the UART. So we will write our rest of the code inside the RX task. Define a variable to keep track of the LED state. If the MCU has received some data, the RX bytes will be greater than zero. Inside this condition, we will compare the received data with the string on. If the received data matches with the string compare function will return zero, and we will set the LED state variable to 1. We will perform a similar check with another string, off, and if it matches, we will reset the LED state to 0. Note that both the strings are in uppercase, so if the computer sends the command in lowercase, it won't be accepted. Now call the function LEDSetLevel, and pass the LED state variable to it. That is all we need, let's build and flash the project to the board. I will start by sending hello. You can see the modified data is transmitted back to the serial monitor. Also, the LED is still off. Now I am sending the command on. The LED is now turned on. And sending the command off turns off the LED. If I send the command in lowercase, there is no change in LED state. Even if you type an extra space after the command, the LED will not respond. It needs to be exactly the same as what we defined in the string compare function. So the LED is responding well, and we can control it using the commands sent from the computer. You can use such commands from the computer to control different tasks on the MCU. This is it for the video. We will cover more UART-related topics in future videos, which includes UART interrupts, events, etc. But for now I will move to some other peripheral in the next video. I want to first cover the basic functioning of the widely used peripherals, and once they all are covered, we will see their complex functions one by one. So in the next video we will look into the I2C peripheral of the ESP32. That is it for today. You can download the project from the link in the description. Leave comments in case of any doubt, or if you have any suggestions. Keep watching, and have a nice day ahead.